and the most important term of accounting is assets. Assets are economic resources of an individual or organization that can be usefully expressed in terms of money. All those things that an individual or an organization possess and they are measured in terms of money is called asset, such as land, building, plant, machinery, furniture, stock, cash and bank balance, debtors, receivables, etc. These are all examples of asset. Thus, assets are valuable resources owned by the business, acquired at money cost, and have tangible and intangible form. Tangible, that can be seen, that can be touched, are all tangible assets, and intangible, that can neither be seen, neither nor touched, but can be felt, such as the goodwill of the. For the first time in revised Schedule 6 to the Companies Act 1956, assets have been classified into current asset and non-current asset. So the first classification of assets was done by the Companies Act 1956 under its Schedule 6. So the current assets are the assets which possess the following characteristics. Number one, it is expected to be realized in or intended for sale or consumption in the company's normal operating cycle. All those assets which are expected to be realized or can be sold or consumed in the normal operating cycle of the company, that is said to be 12 months or a. Number two, it is held primarily for trade. The current assets are generally held for trading purpose. Three, it is expected to be realized within 12 months after reporting date. The day when it is being reported in the books of account, recorded in the books of account. It is assumed that within a period of 12 months, the entire money will be realized. It is cash or cash equivalent unless it is restricted from being exchanged or used to settle a liability for at least 12 months after the reporting time. And it is cash or cash equivalent until and unless it is restricted to discharge a liability within a period of 12 months from the date of recording it in the books of account. In short, current assets are those assets which are likely to be converted into cash within a period of 1 year. This has already been true. For example, cash, bank balance, debtors, bill receivable, stock, short-term investments, prepaid expenses, accrued incomes. These are all examples of current assets. Now the second one is your non-current assets. Non-current assets are defined in a negative sense as the non-current liabilities. That is, assets that are not current assets are non-current assets. For example, fixed assets, non-current investments, they are all non-current assets. Fixed assets includes your land, building, plant, machinery, furniture and so on. So fixed assets are those assets which have physical existence. They can be seen, they can be touched. So they can be seen and touched. That is, for example, your land, building, machinery, and so on. Number two, these fixed assets are further divided into two categories. Number one, tangible assets, those assets which can be seen, which can be touched, and which have a physical appearance. Second, intangible assets, those assets which have no physical existence. They neither can be touched nor can be seen, but they are felt. They, for example, goodwill, patent, trademark, copyright, etc. In real practice, intangible assets are also valuable to the business. Intangible assets also help the company in earning money. If a person says that the goodwill of the firm is not sufficient, no one is going to invest in the firm. Copyright is an intangible asset. So if a person is having the copyright of a particular painting or a particular artistic work, then he can get the royalty throughout his life. The current assets are also called as circulating assets or floating assets, as these assets keep on changing on continuous basis. For example, cash is used to purchase the goods. This purchase of goods become the stock. Some of the goods in the stock are sold to a person and say they will be sold on credit of 2 months. That person will accept a bill of exchange for 2 months, and after the expiry of the 2 months, that person will pay the money. Again, the cash will come, and in this way, this chain keeps on going. Therefore, the current assets are said to be circulating assets too. Some heads of accounts are considered as current asset, though they are never converted into cash. For example, your prepaid expenses. The expenses have already been paid in the current year, and the benefit will be taken in the next year. So in the next year, no cash is going to be generated from such assets, but the benefit is going to be achieved. So such type of assets are also included in the category of current assets. So the third type of asset is your liquid assets. Liquid assets are those assets which are available to business entity either in the form of cash or which are likely to be converted into cash within a very short period. For example, cash, cash at bank, bill receivable, debtors, short-term investments, marketable securities, etc. They are all examples of liquid assets. The formula for calculating the liquid assets is current asset minus stock minus prepaid expenses. Because stock and prepaid expenses are deducted from the current assets, because there is no surety that the entire stock can be converted into cash. And secondly, the prepaid expenses, as I have told you earlier, that they cannot generate cash in the future. Term is the purchases. Purchases is used for the purchase of goods. Goods are the products in which the firm is dealing or producing for sale purposes. Means all those things which are being produced or are being purchased by the business or enterprise for the purpose of selling it. Such type of goods are called as purchases. When the purchases is done in cash, it is called as cash purchase. And when it is done on credit, udhar mein, it is called as credit purchase. Both cash and credit purchases are debited to trading account. Then comes your purchase returns. Goods which have been purchased from the supplier may be returned due to manufacturing defect or due to difference in specifications which the buyer has specified to the manufacturer. Such returns of the goods are known as purchase return or returns outward. Purchase returns are deducted from the purchases to calculate the net purchases which are debited to trading account. Then comes sales. This term is used for sale of only those goods in which the firm is dealing, that is goods bought or produced or possessed for the purpose of selling them. Such goods, such transactions are called as sales. The term sale is never used for sale of assets. It is only used for sale of goods and those goods in which the firm is dealing or is manufacturing. And the main objective behind this deal and manufacture is to sell the goods. If the goods are sold on cash basis, it is called cash sales. And if they are sold on credit basis, it is called credit sales. Sales is shown on the credit side of trading account. Then sales return. If the goods sold to customer is returned by the customer, it is called as sales return or return inward. This happens because the customer feels that there is the variation in size in comparison to the specification of the size that was given to the seller, quality of the goods, and so on. Sales return is deducted from the sales to find out the net sales to be credited to trading account.